your favorite scary movie?
Welcome home, Sydney. Watch the preview of coming events.
Just call me back when you decide to talk. Over 900 gigs, and I don't know what to play. Jeez. No, I think I'll just watch a movie. You scared the crap out of me, man! Man, you're as huge as a building, but quiet as a ninja!
Afraid are you, hmm?
You know, why don't you make yourself useful? We're out of food, so we need groceries. So go.
Yeah, fine, fine. What else do you need?
Yeah. A new partner to review with.
Come on, boy. You love me. Admit it. If I were dead, you would not even know what to do.
Just get the groceries.
One of these days, Matthew. One of these days, you admit you need me.
Forget him. You know, this gives me an idea. I'm gonna review one of my favorite movies of all time. Hell yeah. From Wes Craven, Scream.
It's movie review time! Let's begin with a good slasher named Scream. Scream is a 1996 American slasher film written by Kevin Williamson and directed by Wes Craven. Wes Craven also directed the famous movies called Nightmare on Elm Street with Freddy Krueger. The film stars Neve Campbell, Courtney Cox, Drew Barrymore and David Arquette. Released on December 20, 1996. Scream follows the character of Sidney Prescott, a high school student in the fictional town of Woodsboro, who becomes the target of a mysterious killer known as Ghostface. Other main characters include Sidney's best friend Tatum Riley, Sidney's boyfriend Billy Loomis, film geek Randy Meeks, Deputy Sheriff Dewey Riley, and news reporter Gail Weathers. The film combined comedy and mystery with the violence of the slasher genre to the cliché of the horror genre popularized in films such as Halloween and Friday the 13th. The film was considered unique at the time of its release for featuring characters who were aware of the real-world horror films and openly discussed the cliché that Scream attempted to subvert. They also had rules they must keep on. What rules do I mean? Well, Randy boy, take it away!
Jesus Christ, you don't know the rules?
Have an aneurysm, why don't you?
There are certain rules that one must abide by in order to successfully survive a horror movie. For instance, number one, you can never have sex. Big no-no!
I'm a dead man.
Even in pop, sex equals yes. Death, okay? Number two, you can never drink or do drugs. No, the sin factor. It's a sin, it's an extension of number one. And number three, never, ever, ever, under any circumstances, say, I'll be right back. Because you won't be back.
I'm getting another beer. You want one?
Yeah, sure.
I'll be right back!
I like the suspense they have in this movie, and I watched it so many times. The first time you watch a Scream movie, you're always thinking who the killer is. I like the setting, the flow of the story, and the characters a lot. Speaking of the characters...
What's up?
Nothing much. What's up with you?
Well, not much. Just reviewing stuff.
What's your favorite shitty game?
This sounds familiar.
Do you want to play a shitty game? But also a pretty decent game?
Yes.
Like E.T. on the Atari?
No! Oh, nobody deserves that!
What's that guy anyway? I don't mind. Let's go back to the review.
Maureen Prescott. Maureen Prescott is the mother of Sidney Prescott and wife of Neil Prescott. She is murdered before the events of the Scream films. She conducted several extramarital affairs, including those with Cotton Wary and Hank Loomis, the father of Billy Loomis. Cotton Wary. Cotton Wary was the original suspect in the rape and murder of Maureen Prescott, Sidney's mother. He was identified by Sidney, who found her mother's body after seeing someone she believed to be Cotton leaving her home. Neil Prescott. Neil Prescott is the father of Sidney Prescott and the husband of Maureen Prescott. In Scream, he leaves Woodsboro on business and later disappears without trace, raising suspicions that he may be the perpetrator of the series of murders in the town. Dwight Dewey Riley. Dewey has grown up in a small town of Woodsboro, CA, with his mother and young sister Tatum. When we are first introduced to Dewey, he is in his early 20s and working as a deputy for the Woodsboro Sheriff's Department. In 1996, a string of gruesome murders take place on the one-year anniversary of Maureen Prescott's death, and Dewey is among the police on the case.
So you do watch the show.
Reporter Gail Weathers is on the scene looking for a story when the murders take place, and Dewey falls in love with her.